Hey everyone, Dan here at Fanatik. Today I want to talk to you about the 2021 Specialized Stumpjumper EVO, and specifically the mullet link that we are carrying for it that allows you to run a 27.5-inch rear wheel. Now, if you're familiar with the 2021 Stumpjumper line, you'll know that they've essentially split it into two different bikes. First, we have the Stumpjumper itself, which is now a 130mm rear travel, 140mm front travel bike, in which they've removed the pivot from the rear swing arm. This makes for a lighter bike all around and puts this bike squarely in the trail category that the original Stumpjumper was and that made the bike so popular. I think that's a phenomenal thing, especially because it has allowed Specialized to really refine the Stumpy EVO. Instead of just being a longer reach Stumpjumper, we can see that this has a much more aggressive look. They've bumped it to 150mm rear travel, and it rocks a 160mm fork, and is about as close to an enduro bike as most of us, I think, will ever need. Let's talk a little bit more about it. Specialized has put so much adjustability into the Stumpy EVO frame that you can really cater it exactly to the trails in your area and to your riding level and preferences. There's three head tube angle adjustments that you use these different headset cups to change: steep, middle, and slack. And then there's two bottom bracket height adjustments, giving you a total of six different ways that you can cater the bike to your trails. If you have fast, flowy trails with kickers and booters that you really want to be able to pop off and rail the turns, you could run, say, a low bottom bracket setting so you can have a low center of gravity and a steep head tube angle so you have nimble steering. Or if you have really steep, chunky trails, you could run a high bottom bracket so your pedals don't get caught on stuff and pitch you over, and that slack head tube angle so you can really get down that steep terrain easily. Now, far be it from Specialized to only offer you six different settings for your bike, though, especially now that mixed wheel sizes have really come into vogue. Most homegrown mullet setups have weird effects on suspension, kinematics, as well as geometry, so the bike brands don't often support them. Specialized, however, has seen the light, and they see that there are benefits, especially in terms of cornering and smaller, shorter riders, getting a little more clearance between their rear tire and their bum. So they are offering us this link, which allows you to run a mullet setup on your Stumpy EVO. It has very minimal effects on the geometry. All it does is reduces the chainstay and a whole wheelbase by a few millimeters. Otherwise, everything else stays exactly the same. Now, this mullet link costs $60, and it does come with the bearings pre-installed, which makes swapping it out with the stock link, which you can see there, pretty quick and easy. Still takes a few minutes, so I wouldn't recommend trying to do this right before your next bike ride, but fairly painless procedure. Now, unless you're building this bike up custom in our bike builder, you will also need a 27.5-inch rear wheel to replace your current 29-inch one. So let me, real quick, plug our visual wheel builder. It allows you to not only build only a rear wheel, but you can match the hub and the rim and the spokes exactly to your front one, so you have a matching wheel set. You can also, if you wanted, even put a cassette, a rotor, and tire on there, which would make the whole procedure extremely painless. You just pop your new wheel in when it arrives at your door. I try not to sell you all on things that you don't need, but I'm pretty confident that as far as painless, you know, inexpensive way to get a single rear wheel, our rear wheel builder is a good way to go. So check that out if you're interested. That's all. If trying a mullet setup on your Stumpy EVO is something you want to do, head over to our site, fanaticbike.com, to pick one of these up. We do have a number of other bikes on our website, like the Forbidden Druid, which are mullet compatible. We have the Ziggy Link, actually a pretty big order coming in pretty soon for the Ziggy Link, so you can check that out. Also, our Fanatik Enduro team captain, Eric Olson, who's on a Druid, has been really keen on doing a video where he rides a mullet setup and a regular setup and compares the two to actually like figure out the ins and outs of if there are any benefits to riding a bike like that. Now, if you have any questions about any of this stuff, don't hesitate to let us know in the comments below. If you like watching these videos, please do subscribe to our channel. It helps us out. And otherwise, we'll see you next time. Thanks, y'all.